do their part. We should tell you that we are now joined by Assembly Minority Leader Peter Barca for the Democratic response. And Representative, thanks very much for being here.
Well, thank you, Frederick. It's good with you both.
What's your reaction to the governor's State of the State address?
Well, I was surprised that, you know, there's such divisiveness right now in the state and polarization. I was surprised he didn't try to address that and identify ways that we could come together as a state. Clearly, we have a million plus people that signed petitions to recall the governor, and that wasn't addressed at all. Also, we know that the unemployment rate in this state, we've had job losses 6 months in a row. We're the only state in the nation that for each and every one of the last 6 months has lost jobs. Now, he did say, as you just indicated, that he'd like people to hire another employee each, which that's a good thing to do. But he didn't talk about the fact that we have a whole agenda full of items that we left on the table in the last special session that have yet to be brought forward, despite the fact that some bills passed the assembly, committees, one bill passed unanimously through the Senate, and they're just languishing. So I was surprised he didn't say, let's get back to work. Let's try and bring forward these bills that we never moved forward because we were too busy on all these extreme social issues that tore everybody apart in the fall.
I would imagine the governor would probably tell you there's plenty in here that we can work on. He talked about that education package, talked about this Wisconsin Working proposal he's got out there on job training, job fairs. What about those ideas?
I was glad that he brought up job training and he mentioned the skills gap. He does have a proposal to try and hire veterans, which I think is a great idea, of course. And he's putting forward job fairs, which I have no problem with at all. I think they, you know, marginally could be helpful. But clearly, you know, during his budget process, he cut the vocational colleges by nearly a third. So there's less resources to provide training. And we met with the vocational college boards, private employers, and they're all saying that we do need to close the skills gap. Now, we have a package sitting on the table. Again, I would have loved to have heard him say, let's take that package and move it forward because we know it can help close that skills gap. There's no proposals other than that one that I know of that's on the table. So I'm hoping you could see a sense of bipartisanship, but I didn't see a real reach out to try and accomplish that tonight.
I know that you and the rest of the Democratic minority talk a lot about the number of jobs lost over the past six successive months. Mm-hmm. What do you think is the reason for that?
Well, I think that much like businesses like certainty, I think employees like certainty too. People are unwilling to spend when their future is so uncertain. You know, when you took away collective bargaining, they have no idea next year or 2 years from now where they're going to be. They feel not empowered, so they're not as likely to go out and spend money to get the economy going. Secondly, you have areas like the wind energy where we could have a million people work. I mean, you could have, I think it's 100,000 people. Renew Wisconsin said could be working in $1 billion of investment. But they don't have any certainty because they won't put forward the rules. So I think there's a whole array of different things that we could be doing that we're not doing. And I think the governor, even in his own special session, put forward, I don't know, a couple dozen bills. But virtually none of the bills that had the most promise of putting people back to work were even brought forward for a final vote. So I think that we're missing opportunities here.
What about the mining legislation that was alluded to? You're going to be back in these chambers tomorrow night, potentially late, to discuss that proposal. Republicans are going to talk about that as their big jobs initiative. What do you think about that, and where will your members be on that issue?
Well, see, there's another missed opportunity. When Senator Miller and I met with the governor out at his governor's mansion in August, he had asked Senator Miller and myself to appoint people. He said he was going to bring Democrats and Republicans together on venture capital and on mining. He never followed through on mining, so there was no input put together on this. And I know local officials up in the northern part of the state, I know even some chamber officials I was notified, they don't support the current bill because the resources are not going to be there for them. There's questions about whether or not the drinking water will be safe a generation from now. Now, had he followed through and brought Democrats and Republicans together, I think we could have done this right. I'm still hopeful maybe in the Senate they will, but the bill that they have before us, I doubt we'll get any Democratic votes because there's too many questions about whether or not we can protect the drinking water and other environmental concerns. And certainly the revenue issue is a huge concern for people up in northern Wisconsin. Venture capital is another example. He said he would bring people together. I served personally on the task force. And we had Mark Buehr, who's respected by Democrats and Republicans, chairing it. But as we were getting close to a solution, the governor pulled the plug and ended the task force. So here we are, 2 months, 3 months later, and we have no venture capital bill. And, you know, again, it's hard to understand why he wouldn't want to reach across the aisle, why he wouldn't want to mend this great division we have in Wisconsin. I mean, that's probably why a million plus people in just 2 months signed a petition to recall him, because you just don't see him wanting to bring people together. It's just this strict polarization and divisive policies that I think has torn Wisconsin apart.
We need to leave it there, Representative Peter Barker. Thanks very much for joining us.
Okay, great to be with you. Thank you.